The input power to 6-pole 3-phase 50 Hz induction motor is 42 kW. The speed is 970 rpm. The stator losses are 1.2 kW and the friction and windage losses 1.8 kW. Find the rotor copper losses and the efficiency of the motor. First of all, let us calculate the slip. And for slip, first we have to calculate the synchronous speed. That is NS is equal to 120 F by P. So frequency is given as 50 Hz and number of poles is given as 6. So substitute in this. So we are getting 1000 RPM. Now let us calculate slip S. So slip is the difference of synchronous speed and the rotor speed or the actual speed with respect to synchronous speed. Because the synchronous speed is fixed, so actually it is the relative velocity with respect to the synchronous slip. So we have NS, we have calculated, that is coming to be 1000 RPM. NR, that is rotor speed, is given, that is 970 RPM divided by 1000. We are getting slip as 0.03. Or in percentage we can multiply it with 100, or that is 3% we will get as slip. So the stator losses, friction, windage losses are given, and we have to find rotor copper losses and the efficiency of the motor. So efficiency of the motor will be output by input, that is output power by input power in percentage into 100. So first of all, for calculating efficiency and other losses, we need to study the power flow of induction motor. So this is the equivalent circuit for a induction motor, as you know, very similar to transformer. It is also known as a rotating transformer. Only the difference between the transformer and induction motor equivalent circuit will be the slip. It is, you can see S here and here. So coming to power, I can write the power input will be equal to the stator losses plus the rotor input, I can write. And you know that in rotor the mechanical power will be developed. So I can further extend this rotor input into two types. That is, one will be rotor losses and the other will be mechanical power developed in rotor. And please note that these losses will be what? These losses will be the core and the copper losses, that is iron and copper losses. Okay, so I can keep a plus here. I can further extend the mechanical power into two parts again. It is, when the rotor is rotating, there will be losses, that is friction and windage losses will be there in rotating machine. And the last part is nothing but motor's output, or the rotor's output, I must say. So this is the rotor or the motor output, or that is our P out, and the starting one was P in. So efficiency is P out by P in into 100. Now coming back to the question, the stator losses are given and the friction and windage losses are given to us. And also you can notice that the input power is also given, that is 42 kilowatts. So we saw just now, that is, or I can tell that from these two I can find the rotor's input, because we just now saw that the input power was stator losses plus rotor's input, or the input to the rotor. Now we know P in and stator losses. Now let's substitute. So from here I am getting my rotor's input, that is the input power to the rotor, that is 40.8 kilowatt. Also, I said you that the rotor's input was equal to rotor copper loss, that is rotor losses plus the mechanical power developed, or we are representing by P mechanical. So we have found out this. We have to find the rotor copper loss, and we don't know still the mechanical power. So first let's find our mechanical power and then again find the rotor copper loss. But we still don't know the output power and P mechanical. So from this relation also we cannot calculate the mechanical power, or in turn we cannot calculate the rotor copper loss or the efficiency. So now there will be an important relationship in the induction machine, that is the rotor's input is to mechanical power is to rotor copper loss will be equal to 1:1 minus s is to s, where s is the slip. So this is the very important relationship in the induction motor. So here I know the slip, okay, so all s value I know, that is 0.03, and rotor's input also I know, that is we have calculated as 40.8 kilowatt. I don't know this, I don't know this, so I can calculate both of them by this relationship. So if this be 1, 2 and 3, so if I take first and third relationship, that is the rotor copper loss is to the, sorry, the rotor's input is to the rotor copper loss will be 1:s, that is 1/s. So first I will be taking 1:3. So from this I am getting the rotor copper loss, that is I am denoting with PRCU suffix, P suffix RCU, that is 1.224 kilowatts. Okay, now I will take the other relationship. So now either I can take P rotor input by P mechanical as 1/1 minus s, or I can take P mechanical by P rotor copper losses 1/1 minus s/s by the relationship, because now we have found out PRCU. Okay, either of them we can take. So I will take this. Okay, so from this relationship I am getting the mechanical power as 39.58 kilowatt. You can take the other relationship which we left out and you can verify it for yourself. You will get the same result. Now we already discussed that the mechanical power to the rotor will be equal to the friction and windage losses of the rotor plus the output power. So from here I will get my output, because this is given already in question, that is 1.8 kilowatt is given. P mechanical we have found out to be 39.58 kilowatt. Now let's substitute. So I am getting the output power as 37.78 kilowatt. So we have already found out the rotor copper losses, that is it is coming to be 1.224 kilowatt. Now the efficiency I already said you, that is output by input, that is output we have got just now, that is 37.78 kilowatt, and the input it is already given in the question, that is 42 kilowatts. Now let us substitute and find our efficiency like this. So the efficiency is coming out to be 89.95%. Okay, you can also verify the powers what we got by the relationship that we discussed at the starting of the video, or I will only write it down. So this was the power flow, and you can also verify, and the red color ones is the already given in question, and the maroon ones are that we found out, or that is we calculated. So according to our question, we have found out the rotor copper losses. Where our rotor? Here our rotor copper losses, that has 1.224 kilowatts, and we have found out the efficiency, that is output by input, that is 37.78 divided by 42, that was coming to be 89.95%. Okay, and please remember this important relationship. Okay, the rotor input is to mechanical is to rotor copper loss is equal to 1:1 minus s/s. You can write it either way also, but these will also change accordingly. So please remember this. This is also called gross power. Okay, thank you.